In 1950, he received the gold medal. See, now I wish to refer to the appreciation that Marcel Junod had for his humanitarian activities. In 1950, he received the gold medal for peace of Prince Carl of Sweden for his exemplary humanitarian service. In 1961, he was posthumously, after his death, he was awarded the Order of the Sacred Treasure by the government of Japan. A monument was erected in his honor in the Hiroshima Peace Park, and each year on the anniversary of his death, a commemorative meeting was held in front of the monument. A similar meeting is held, a similar monument is there in Geneva also, on this monument is engraved the words of Junod: "Those who call for help are many. It is you they are calling." Once again, in 1950, he received the gold medal for peace of Prince Carl of Sweden for his exemplary humanitarian service. In 1961, he was posthumously awarded the Order of the Sacred Treasure by the government of Japan. A monument was erected in his honor in the Hiroshima Peace Park. Each year on the anniversary of his death, a commemorative meeting is held in front of the monument. And a similar monument was inaugurated in Geneva in 2005. And on this monument is engraved the words of Junod: "Those who call for help are many. It is you they are calling." Our very touching words. And so, now coming to the lesson, the first atom bomb. What is this lesson about? The first atom bomb is a graphic and a gripping first-hand account of the dropping of the first ever nuclear bomb in Hiroshima. It recounts the horrific incidents that unleashed thereafter, wiping out 90% of the city, killing 80,000 people instantly, and exposing generations to the pernicious after effects of radiation. And so, in one line, what is this lesson about? A very touching account, a first-hand account of the dropping of the first ever nuclear bomb in Hiroshima. It is about the dropping of the first nuclear bomb in Hiroshima. What is the date? You could never forget that date. It is August 6th, 1945. The first atom bomb was dropped in Hiroshima. What happened? Nearly 90% of people, animals, birds, everything was wiped out of Hiroshima. Once a very prosperous place. 80,000 people were killed instantly on the spot. And after that, within days, many people who suffered great burns, they died day by day. And even the green grass have become brown like hay. Animals, birds, all of them suffer the same fate. And it is also about the after effects of radiation. The bomb named Little Boy was the result of several years of scientific research pioneered by the US under the code name the Manhattan Project. And so, what is the name of the first atom bomb? It's called the Little Boy. This little boy, it was made after years of research by the US government. They had even had a project called the Manhattan Project. And after years of research, the atomic bomb was made. And it was dropped in Hiroshima on August 6, 1945. Actually, the first successful test of the atomic device, it was a plutonium bomb. It was conducted on July 16, 1945. And so, the first atomic test was conducted on July 16, 1945 in a site in New Mexico. And so, U.S. for years conducted research work on the usage of nuclear bombs, and the first test was conducted in July 16, 1945 in a site in New Mexico. And for the first time, the nuclear bomb was dropped in Hiroshima on August 6th. So the first successful test of the atomic device was conducted at Trinity test site in New Mexico. And now I am explaining the situation which forced US to drop the first nuclear bomb in Hiroshima on August 6th. What are the circumstances that led to the dropping of the first ever nuclear bomb in Hiroshima on August 6th, 1945? Even after the defeat of Germany by the Allied powers, Japan relentlessly fought the war, posing a grave threat to the Allied powers. That is, Germany was defeated, but Japan was not ready to accept the defeat. And so Japan relentlessly fought the war. And it posed a grave threat to the Allied powers. President Truman believed that the nuclear bomb would bring an end to the war and establish U.S. as a dominant power in the world. And the President Truman forgot that force cannot bring an end to a war. And so when Japan was not ready to surrender, what did U.S. do? They decided to drop the first ever nuclear bomb in Hiroshima. Why? Because the president thought that, President Truman believed that the bomb will bring an end to the war and it will establish U.S. as a superpower, as the most dominant power in the world. And with that intention, he gives orders to drop the first bomb in Hiroshima on August 6, 1945. U.S. was not ready to think of the consequences of a nuclear war. How it affects the people, how it will affect generations to come. These are not the issues of the U.S. people. U.S. want to be the most dominant power. And so they dropped the atomic bomb in Hiroshima on August 6th. Where is this place, Hiroshima? And what was the significance of this place, Hiroshima? The main attraction of Hiroshima is that it was a very prosperous place, a beautiful place. It was a manufacturing center of some 350,000 people located about 500 miles from Tokyo. Yeah, and it was selected as the first target. And so US decided to drop the first nuclear bomb in Hiroshima, which was a manufacturing center with about 350,000 people. And this Hiroshima was 500 miles from Tokyo. And US selected Hiroshima as the first target for their atomic bomb. And do you know what happened? The 9,000 pound uranium-235 bomb aboard a modified B-29 plane was dropped by parachute at 8:15 in the morning, and it exploded 2,000 feet above Hiroshima. It was the first ever nuclear attack. Understood? The 9,000 pound uranium-235 bomb aboard a modified B-29 plane was dropped by parachute at 8:15 in the morning, and it exploded 2,000 feet above Hiroshima.